Hello, my name is Victoria Niederhauser, and I'm the Dean at the University of Tennessee Knoxville College of Nursing. Although many forms of racism have existed for many years, recent disturbing events have brought this topic to the forefront, and demands for not only the identification of racial injustices, but action to promote a more just society and improve health equity are at an all-time high. So, what can academic nursing do to put an end to structural racism? First, we need to look inward at ourselves to identify our own perspective and lenses. This will take creating a safe environment to conduct critical self-reflection so that we can begin to understand about how our experiences and our past affect beliefs, privilege, power, and action. There are several ways this can be done. Individually reflecting by unpacking our own personal racialized history, recounting how you noticed your race or the race of others in your childhood, during your education, in your professional career, and/or your personal life. Additionally, using tools like the Intercultural Development Inventory, known as IDI, can provide ways to assess cultural competence and provide important feedback through individual counseling. In addition to individual reflection, routine organizational assessments can help academic nursing self-reflect on how they can better undo racism in society. Two examples of tools are the Anti-Racist Organizational Assessment and Moving to a Racial Justice Agenda, Are You Ready? I encourage you to hold your faculty and staff accountable by having them participate in trainings that encourage individual and organizational self-awareness and reflection. Second, academic nursing needs to take a look at structures that are in place that impede diversity, equity, and inclusion. Multiple stakeholders must examine policies and procedures, like admission, hiring, recruiting, administrative appointments, promotion and tenure, and student progression processes, which may create inequities and barriers to diverse people. For example, AACN has many tools to assist programs to reduce structural barriers to admission by creating holistic assessment processes. Third, we cannot sit still. We must take action. We must understand how to make change happen. Once inequities or unjust policies and/or procedures are identified, we must implement rapid change. We also must take bold steps to create new policies that foster a more inclusive and diverse environment in our colleges. For example, nursing curriculums could adopt an anti-racist framework that focuses on self-reflection, awareness, and critical conversations. And we need to evaluate change by creating outcome metrics to measure accurately and frequently. We must be nimble to redirect if we do not meet our projected outcomes. Tennessee Nursing has made a bold commitment to diversity, equity, and inclusion. This commitment is clear in our mission statement. We are catalysts for optimizing health through nurse-led care by integrating education, practice, research, and technology. We define health broadly and impact it by addressing policy and social issues through advocacy and leadership. Fueled by our commitment to communities, families, and individuals, we seek partnerships to create innovative solutions that improve health for all. At Tennessee Nursing, we've begun the journey, recognizing it's not a sprint, but a marathon. Along the road, we will discover, stumble, trip, and fall. But as nurses, we don't give up. We will all learn and grow together, and we will look to a brighter future where there's equity, inclusion, and diversity in health and healthcare for all.